Welcome back. The NDP has launched what it calls the Forward Fund, which according to their website masks future for the New Democratic Party and St. Vincent and the Grenadines. The monthly donation program encourages support from Vincentians abroad to help the fund NDP's campaign for democratic transparency, party operations and future elections. According to the party website, persons can make a minimum of $10 donation to join the Forward Fund and help write our country's next chapter. On Tuesday, the Garifuna Heritage Foundation launched its program of activities, which will be held to coincide with National Heroes and Heritage Month in March of this year. This year's Garifuna activities will take place from March the 6th to the 15th under the theme Celebrating Our Indigenous History, Heritage and Cultures from Mainland to Islands and Return. Strengthening links, forging networks, claiming ancestral space.
For years, the Garifuna Heritage Foundation has been carrying out its mandate of education and culture within St. Vincent and the Grenadines, and it has even extended its wings towards the region and internationally. This year, during the month of March, which is normally our Heritage Month, the Garifuna Heritage Foundation, in collaboration with the University of the West Indies Open Campus, they are really proud to present the International Garifuna Summit. It will be held between March 6th and 13th, and the theme would be celebrating our indigenous heritage and culture from mainland to islands and return, strengthening links, forging networks, claiming ancestral space.
At yesterday's launch, Gloria Williams from the Garifuna Heritage Foundation says this year's program will be a hive of excitement and knowledge for everyone. She stated that the Garifuna Heritage Foundation, in collaboration with the University of the West Indies Open Campus, will be presenting the International Garifuna Summit, which will be held between March 6th and 13th.
The thing is, it sounds lengthy, and right now you may be wondering about all those terms. But just tell yourselves this, members of the media, because hereinafter, we would like you to be able to disseminate this information in such an exciting way that people clamor to be a part of these activities. It is going to be a whole hive of excitement because the summit, you notice we have from the 6th to the 13th of March, would engage persons of different levels and from throughout the entire country of St. Vincent and the Grenadines. I say that because within those days, you would have the International Garifuna Conference, you would have the screening of Garifuna documentaries, the hosting of the annual school's Garifuna Folk Festival, the traditional Garifuna Village, which is going to be really out of this world, the Garifuna Cultural Marketplace, this is going to be at Heritage Square right near us here, and the hosting of the International Garifuna Dance and Music Festival. Now, we can't get better than that. Now, it may sound as if it's just excitement and fun, but it is structured in such a way that within the excitement, you are learning, you are gleaning about the culture, and you are going to take away valuable information.
Meanwhile, David Darkey Williams, president of the Garifuna Heritage Foundation, said while they have enjoyed tremendous success with their activities during Heroes and Heritage Month over the years, the year they will be taking the program up is a notch. He said there will be many presentations from local, regional, and international delegates, and the program will also feature a number of fun, informative events for nation's population, especially the youth, to learn about Garifuna heritage.
Another very important aspect of our program for that month is the school's Garifuna Folk Festival. And that would be held at Victoria Park, and when Miss Maxine Brown comes to the podium, she would elaborate and give you more details. Of course, in this venture, we are partnering with the University of the West Indies Open Campus. And again, when Ms. Dalrymple comes, you would hear in more detail how UWI Open Campus collaborates with us. Our next two partners comes from the government, two government ministries, the Ministry of Education and the Ministry of Culture.
The governor of the Eastern Caribbean Central Bank, ECCB, Timothy Antoine, is urging Caribbean governments administering citizenship by investment CIP programs to be more transparent and not use the funds collected for recurrent expenditure. A number of countries within the Eastern Caribbean Currency Union offer CIPs in a bid to lure foreign investors to their countries. Antigua and Barbuda, Dominica, Grenada, St. Kitts and Nevis, and St. Lucia. Under the program, investors receive citizenship of these lands in return for marking or making substantial investment to socioeconomic development of the countries. Antoine is telling the governments of these islands that they should be more transparent by publishing all of the flows in the ins and outs of the funds. A pilot project aimed at rehabilitating inmates at Her Majesty's Prison in Kingstown and at the Belle Isle Correctional Facility commenced yesterday. The program is being coordinated by the Ministry of Social Development in collaboration with the Prison Service. Anton Caesar, an official of the Ministry of Social Development, said about 25 inmates are involved in the program, with sessions being held at Her Majesty's Prison in Kingstown and the Belle Isle Correctional Facility. Persons here in St. Vincent and the Grenadines are being urged to attend and actively participate in the series of public consultation on the National Broadband Plan, the NBP, which is set underway here later this month. The consultations are being hosted by the Ministry of Economic Planning, Sustainable Development, Industry, Labour and Information to seek feedback from stakeholders to finalise the National Broadband Plan. Speaking at a ceremony yesterday morning to launch the consultations, Director of the National Telecommunications Regulatory Commission, NTRC, Mr. Apollo Knights, in providing an update on the current status of broadband in this country, said about 40% of householders have broadband. Meanwhile, Minister of Economic Planning and Information, Camille Gonsalves, said there's a need here for broadband that is available, fast, affordable, and reliable. Minister Gonsalves is appealing to persons to attend the consultations and share their ideas, comments, and complaints, since their active and robust input is vital to the quality of finalization of the National Broadband Plan. This Saturday, Dr. Ken Onu, motivational speaker and ophthalmologist, will be presenting a lecture on the topic Design Your Life as part of a series of lectures which are aimed at encouraging persons to transform their outlook at life. He stated that the idea is to promote a positive change in both their professional and personal lives, as happiness is a byproduct of achieving our goals. Dr. Ono will also be focusing on several other areas during the lecture series, including learning strategies such as memory techniques, brain training, mind mapping, and speak reading courses. There will also be courses on procrastination, empowerment, communication skills, time management, overcoming adversity, and creating visualization. Saturday's lecture takes place at the Center for Inner Vision upstairs the Sports Building this Saturday, beginning at 2 p.m. According to another radio station, a travel agency in Canada is hoping to finalize plans to facilitate persons in Canada who wish to travel to St. Vincent and the Grenadines on the inaugural Sunwing Airlines flight on February 14, 2017. Once everything is finalized, persons in Canada, including Vincentians residing in Canada, can book their spaces on the February 14 inaugural Sunwing Airlines flight with GG Tours. The chartered flight will depart from Toronto, Canada, nonstop, to Argyle International Airport, AIA, in St. Vincent and the Grenadines. Chief Executive Officer, CEO of the St. Vincent and the Grenadines Tourism Authority, Glenn Beach, has asked persons to desist from calling Sunwing Airlines to book flights to St. Vincent from Canada on February 14th. Speaking at the launch of the 40th anniversary of Vincent Mass last night, Beach said that persons are not going to find flights to St. Vincent on Sunwing's listings because it is a chartered flight and the tickets would not be sold by the airline but through a tour operator out of Toronto called GG Tours. More local news after this commercial break.